There's nowhere at all I'd rather be today than here at Hockenheim for the German Grand Prix. We have an incredibly competitive field this year, which means we should be in for a treat. And judging by the sea of people filling the grandstands, there's a fair-sized chunk of Germany that agrees with me. With average lap speeds of around 130 miles per hour, the Hockenheim Ring is a quick circuit with a lap distance of 2.8 miles, around 17 corners. The main DRS zone through Parabolica leads into the hairpin for the best overtaking opportunity on the track. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about Red. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
It's been a really solid year so far. There have been some incredible standout performances, but what's really impressed me has been the consistency. With this kind of form, I'm expecting another great race today.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Red lines up on pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Hülkenberg, Daniel Ricciardo, and Perez, Grosjean, Sainz, Gasly, and Kevin Magnussen, Alonso, Hamilton. They've taken a grid penalty. Charles Leclerc and Ericsson, Verstappen, Sirotkin, Stoffel Vandoorne, and Esteban Ocon, Stroll, and Brendan Hartley rounds off the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
Jeff here, radio check. Check, check, can you hear me? Okay, we had a fantastic result at the last race. Let's try it again here. Right, let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can. race.
So here they come now, out onto the podium. Wherever you go, anywhere in the world, the Prancing Horse flags are dominant in the grandstands, and they're out in force again today. It's Ferrari on the top step once more. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Red increases their championship lead. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, I have to give it to Lewis Hamilton. You know, it was just the kind of drive you'd expect from a multiple world champion.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Mercedes moved to the top of the table. After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us, and goodbye until the next race.